some stories serve as a reminder that even in the darkest of times, love, if genuine, can overcome the most significant challenges, but my story was not one of them. My wife and I lived in a small town nestled between rolling hills. I was always an outdoors person and I thought this was the perfect location to raise a family. I have nothing against big cities, but I like to go to the party and not live in the party. My wife and I had been high school sweethearts, our love blossoming amidst the quaint charm of our hometown. Our bond was unbreakable, or so I thought. For over 18 years, my wife and I shared everything, our dreams, secrets, and even our darkest fantasies. We were the epitome of a perfect couple, but beneath the surface, cracks had begun to appear, threatening to shatter our idyllic life. Our inability to juggle work, family, and career was starting to put a strain on our marriage. I had this part in to take ownership of my part in our life, but what family does not have work-life balance struggles? My wife, female 36, was a successful architect, dedicated to her demanding job, while I, 35, male, was a devoted teacher, known for my unwavering commitment to my students. Our careers mirror the difference in our personalities. I'm the people-pleaser caregiving type, an introvert by nature and an extrovert by confidence, while my wife is more of a type A personality. Our lives were busy, filled with meetings, lesson plans, business trips, and never-ending to-do lists. Slowly, the distance between us grew, and we found ourselves spending less and less time together. Following the aftermath of my wife's affair, the conversation we had on how the affair started, my wife shared the details the way she remembered them. One evening, Emma's project deadline loomed. She had been working tirelessly for weeks, pouring all her energy into her designs. Exhausted and stressed, she decided to stay late at the office to finish the project. Little did she know that this decision would set in motion a chain of events that would forever alter the course of our lives. As Emma worked late into the night, her phone buzzed incessantly with messages and missed calls from me. Ignoring them at first, she finally picked up the phone, her heart sinking as she listened to the worry in my voice. I had planned a surprise romantic dinner at our favorite restaurant, hoping to rekindle our fading connection. Oliver, who was empathetic and charming, became a source of comfort for my wife. I found this part to be amusing since it was my wife who refused to cut back on her working hours. I had stopped all my after-school tutoring and was home trying to focus on our marriage. Oliver, being the snake he was, listened to my wife's worries, offered advice, and provided the emotional support she felt was missing from her relationship. Slowly, my wife's feelings for Oliver began to blur the lines between friendship and something more. One day about 6 months ago, as my wife and Oliver were working late together in the dimly lit office, their shared vulnerability led to what my wife described as a moment of weakness. They kissed, and my wife was torn between guilt and desire, knowing that what she had done was unforgivable. The affair continued in secret, my wife said, intensifying the emotional turmoil within her. She tried to justify her actions, convincing herself that this was a temporary escape from her failing relationship. But every night she spent with Oliver only made her feel more isolated from me. At this point, I had to ask her why did she continue the affair, and she said she did not know how to stop the affair. I said it looked like it was more your lack of desire to stop the affair. While the affair continued, I began to sense that something was amiss. I noticed the subtle changes in my wife's behavior, the way she withdrew emotionally and seemed distant. My intuition gnawed at me, but I couldn't bring myself to confront the woman he loved with his suspicions. While my wife was working late again, I decided to surprise her with a home-cooked dinner. I had hoped that a romantic gesture would bridge the growing divide between them. But when he arrived at their empty house, he found a note from her, explaining that she needed time alone to clear her head. For everybody who is reading this post, if your wife tells you she needs alone time to clear her head, what she means is she is trying to decide if she wants you or the other guy. I was devastated that I went through the efforts of preparing a surprise dinner and my wife would not be home again. I couldn't shake the feeling that something was wrong. I confided in a close friend, who urged him to confront my wife and uncover the truth. The next day, I decided to follow her discreetly. My heart was heavy and I had a growing sense of dread. I kept telling myself that my wife would never cheat on me, she loved me, but I was only trying to lessen the blow. I knew the truth. What I discovered shattered my world, hopes, and dreams. I watched in anguish as my wife and her coworker embraced in a passionate kiss outside a cafe. Their betrayal lay bare before me. Tears streamed down my face as I realized the depth of the deception, the love I had believed in for so long reduced to a painful memory. I composed myself, took out my phone, and took her pictures. Overwhelmed by a surge of emotions, I confronted my wife, made a big scene at the cafe, punched her coworker, and got the police called on me. I was put in handcuffs and taken to the police station. The next day I was arraigned and let go of my reconnaissance because I did not have a record. I didn't go home, I went to my friend's house and asked him if I could stay with him. He said yes. The next day I asked my friend to go by my house and pick up a few things. By this time word had spread in our small town and I was asked to meet with the principal before I would be allowed to go back to work. I called the principal and we met that afternoon. I was honest and upfront with him, and I was put on suspension with pay. When I got back to my friend's house, he told me my wife asked about me and he said I'm doing the best I could under the circumstances. He asked her why she was home and she said she was under investigation for violation of the workplace fraternization policy. My wife was worried she would lose her job, which would be bad timing. She was in line for a major promotion. After a week off with no contact with my wife, I blocked her on everything. She stopped by my friend's house and tried to talk to me. He told her to go away and don't come back or he would call the police. My boss, the principal, called me and told me I had to complete an anger management class and after I did I could return to work. He went to bat for me with the school board who wanted to fire me. They have a kind of no tolerance for violence policy. I got off luck and went back to work the next week. My wife and her coworker were told one of the two had to either accept a transfer or quit, but they both cannot continue to work at the same place. By this time my wife's AP wife had gotten wind of the affair, kicked him out of the house, and filed for divorce. He was up shit creek because his wife was a lawyer who worked for the best firm in the town. He was taken to the cleaners in the divorce and transferred to one of the other offices in another state. The police charged me with disturbing the public due to AP refusing to press charges. The police wanted to drop the charges, but there were too many videos of me fighting my wife's coworker, so they had to charge me with something so they would not appear to be soft on crime. The funny part is QP's wife represented me for free. I did speak with my wife. We had a tearful, heart-wrenching conversation that left both of us broken. My wife confessed to the affair, her voice trembling with guilt and remorse. She admitted that she had strayed because she felt neglected and unfulfilled in their relationship. For weeks, we wrestled with the aftermath of the affair. The pain of betrayal haunted me, and our love story, once celebrated by all who knew us, ended in sorrow and heartbreak. My wife's mother and father found out about the affair and was so disappointed in her. Her father did not speak with her for a year until her mother convinced him that she deserved another chance. We divorced a year later and I started working on my master's degree. I'm going to become a principal, and my ex-wife quit her job because she was the constant talk of the office. She moved in with her younger sister and worked at the cafe where I busted her and her AP. When I reflect on my marriage, it serves as a painful reminder that even the strongest relationships can falter when neglected and communication falters. It's a cautionary tale of how a moment of weakness can lead to a lifetime of regret, forever altering the course of two people who were once deeply in love. I no longer block my wife and I hear from her now and again. She is dating a guy and seems to be doing okay. Me, well, I'm seeing AP's ex-wife and I think I might find love again. OP. You came into their life to show them the meaning of true love, but they came into your life to show you the meaning of self-love. Your wife had a choice before she started her affair and she chose to think of herself and not her marriage. I, 42M, caught my wife, 42F, cheating, What and how I am supposed to tell my children? I don't even know where to start. I am so devastated and have been crying. I and my wife have been married for 24 years now and have known each other for 26 years. We have two children who are 21 and 17. All these years there have been no problems at all. She has been a friendly, loving, and caring mother and wife. Since the past 2 weeks, she has been acting differently. She has been a little rude at times, and a little aggressive. She never acted this way in the past. I was supposed to travel for a few days due to work. My children were at my mom's for the weekend. When I reached the airport, my flight was delayed for 4 hours. Then they said the flight had been canceled and they would put me on the flight for the next day, so I came back home. It was around 11:30 p.m. or so when I reached home. My wife did not know I was coming back. When I opened the door, that is when I just went into a big shock. There was some sort of party going around. There were around 10 to 15 people. I recognized 4 or 5 of them who were the co-workers of my wife, but others I had never seen before. The whole place was a mess, so many bottles, and one person was even drawing something on my furniture. I looked for my wife and then I saw her making out with another woman who was her co-worker. I was extremely shocked and started crying. She saw me and panicked. I told everyone to get the hell out of my house. I have been sitting in the living room for the past few hours now. My wife is in the bedroom at the moment. I did get angry and shout at her. I do want her to leave. I feel so devastated at the moment. My daughters are supposed to come over in the evening. I don't know what am I even supposed to tell them, and how should I tell them, cause it will break them apart too. This co-worker is new at her place. She joined a month ago, and within a few weeks, she decided to cheat on me with this woman over me who she has kids with and has known for so many years. I guess her behavior change happened cause of that woman, but how so fast? It makes no sense to carry on this relationship. I guess it will head to divorce. Can anyone guide me with the basics? I know I would need to find a good lawyer, but any idea how much do they charge? All these years my wife never fleeced money out of me, and she contributed in whatever she could. She was not the type of a person who demanded things, but well, now I can't say anything because I didn't expect her to cheat. The house is in my name. My daughter, who is 17, will turn 18 at the end of this month. What things can my wife claim for? TLDR, my wife cheated on me. I caught her with a co-worker. My children don't know about this. When they come home, what and how should I tell them? Any guidance for this whole situation would be helpful. OP, close the windows that hurt you, no matter how beautiful the view is. Thank you for listening to today's story. Please comment below on your opinion of today's story. If there is a story you would like to share with me, please email the story to me. If you are not subscribed, please take the time to subscribe and like, and I will see you in the following story. Take care.